What do I have to expect today?
On guard.
Oh, yeah.
This stuff is way harder than it looks on TV.
There's a million and one reasons I love New England, from its awesome natural range of recreation. So is it dangerous?
I'm definitely in uncharted waters.
And you're flying.
To its natural beauty.
Man, that was awesome.
This has to be one of New England's best kept secrets. Boston's my town, and I'm gonna show you a side of it you've never seen before.
Let's make some funny TV.
Growing up, I played all kinds of sports, and I was always very physically active. You guys know about my hockey career, right?
It's easy to find something you love in such a sports-loving city as Boston.
Well, today we're gonna try some new sports and some new activities to see if I still got what it takes. Come along with me and let's find out together. Are you Jason?
Jason.
Rob.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you too.
How's it going?
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
This is a pretty serious gym you have here, right? Are we in South Boston, Seaport, kind of right in between?
Kind of like the Fort Point area, like Seaport, I would say.
And you guys have been here a while?
13 years.
I hear that you're gonna give me a little bit of a workout today.
We're gonna go through it, for
sure. So a long time ago when I was in college, I took a couple boxing classes, but nothing really serious.
Okay.
What do I have to expect today?
We're gonna have some fun, but you're gonna get a good workout for sure.
All right.
We'll go through like the proper technique and fundamentals, go through some fun stuff.
All right, let's do it. I'll get changed.
Awesome, man.
All right, Jason, ready to go.
Let's get the hands wrapped first.
Okay. Is boxing a big sport in Boston?
It is. It's a big sport. We don't get a lot of the recognition we deserve. A lot of great fighters out of here.
Right.
Yeah.
So do you guys have anybody from this gym that is fighting professionally?
We have both amateur and professional fighters. Professional fighters, there's some here right now actually getting some work in. Johnny DePina is an amazing professional boxer. We have Francis Hogan, Frank the Tank. We also have Mark DeLuca, the Bazooka. So we have a lot of really great professional fighters here.
What are like the common misconceptions about the sport of boxing?
That these guys are in there to kill each other, right?
Right.
When it's really more of an art. It's a sport, right? Based on a point system.
Right.
So keeping your composure, timing everything right, and keeping the proper fundamentals and technique, that's super important.
All right, let's get to work.
Let's do it.
So what is this here?
The speed bag here is great for hand-eye coordination.
Okay.
So what you want to do is you want to keep your hands closed in a fist. You want to hit it with the back of your hand, and you want to hit it at a downward motion. Boom, you're going to hit it like that. The bag is going to go back, forward, and back. And that's when you want to roll over it and hit it again. And then when you can start incorporating your other hand, pick up the speed a little bit.
Got it.
Always keeping that opposite hand right back on that face.
We'll superimpose your hands in with me doing it. No, I'm just kidding. Let me try.
Nice. Great. There you go.
This is obviously, I'm a beginner, but how long do you work the speed bag?
Typically, I have my fighters do three rounds, three-minute rounds.
Whoa!
Yeah.
That's gonna be tiring on the shoulder. This is definitely a workout. What's up next?
All right, next we got some heavy bag work.
Okay.
On the heavy bag, you wanna get a lot of output while keeping good form and technique.
Okay.
Got some gloves for you here.
Okay.
So I want you to maintain an angle, okay? Don't face the bag.
Okay.
With your body frame towards it. You want your front shoulder facing the bag and your back shoulder behind you. Keep that elbow nice and tight. And then you want your right hand rested right across your cheek. Drop it down a little bit low, right there.
Okay.
Perfect. Now get a nice bend. And when you throw your one, your jab, take a little step, right? Hit the bag. And then when you throw your two, really pivot that upper body and the back leg. Yeah, perfect. Good, so give me that one. Good. Double it. Nice. One, two. Good. Much better. All right, man, you want to see what you can do in the ring?
I mean, if you think I'm ready.
I think you're ready.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. All right, now we're gonna take what we used on the bag.
Right.
We're gonna start incorporating some footwork to it, right? You need to be able to walk and punch
right.
at the same time, okay? Is I actually just want you to give me a triple jab forward. Triple jab forward, ready?
Yep.
Go ahead. Good. Good. Nice. Double it. I think you look more natural this way.
In the 1970s, it was frowned upon to be left-handed.
Yeah.
My parents made me righty. But all the things they didn't teach me, like playing hockey and boxing and stuff,
okay.
I do left-handed now.
Okay, okay.
So I never know.
All right. Now we're gonna give me a 1-2.
I spent most of last year with my arm in a cast. So let me tell you, it feels good to use both arms today. Let's just hope I don't break anything again.
He can keep up. I'm out of breath right now. I'm sweating. Dude.
Woo! I'll tell you what, Jason, that was awesome.
Good work.
If you guys want to have some fun, learn the art of boxing and a great workout, come on down to Everybody Fights. See my man, Jason. He'll hook you up. Thanks, guys. What a workout, man. That was awesome. Thank you.
Boxing was a blast, and I think I finally mastered my right hook. Next up, I'm headed to Weymouth, Mass. For a Ninja Warrior obstacle course. And I've got no clue how well I'm gonna keep up.
How you doing? I'm Rob.
Dave, nice to meet you.
Dave, good to meet you. Wow, this place is awesome.
Thanks, man.
So what do you got going on here?
Right here, we do mostly functional fitness through obstacles. So if you've seen the show like American Ninja Warrior or Spartan Tough Mudders, those kind of things, we train everyone from all that stuff.
My kids are huge fans of American Ninja Warrior.
Nice. So this is going to be right up your alley, right?
Yeah, this looks like something that they would have a ball on, but you guys are doing it with adults, huh?
Yeah, we do it with kids too, as young as 3, so okay. All the way.
How did you get involved?
There was a big group of people around here that didn't have a place to go.
Right.
So we're like, what are we gonna do? Because Massachusetts, you know, snow and you can't do anything outside anymore.
Bad weather.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
So we opened up our own little space, a couple obstacles, you know, got some other functional fitness stuff in there, and eventually, boom. That's the best way to describe it.
What are we gonna do today?
We're gonna run you through some simple obstacles, some tougher obstacles, some stuff from the show, see how many of them you can get down.
So is it dangerous to train like
this? I think
this?
It can be a little dangerous, but if you do it safely with proper equipment, I think you'll be fine.
I got 4 kids at home. Take care of me today.
I think we'll be all right.
Where do I get changed?
We got bathrooms right over there, my friend.
So what should we start with? Something easy.
Something easy?
Yeah.
All right. We call these devil steps.
Okay.
So the idea is to use your arms to basically pull yourself up, right? You can put both hands on each to kind of like work your way up. So the beginning thing is like here to here, right? So kind of like that's pulling. So
okay.
If you can't pull all that much, bring your knee up so that way you can kind of put both, like you're making yourself a little lighter.
Good idea.
Not bad. That's pretty good.
I don't want to die on the first thing. But yeah, I can see how that's difficult. They do the same thing with that one, that
So the idea is like you go up and down or down this way.
I think the key to something like this, low body weight. So you don't have to pull as much.
That does help a little bit.
Maybe we got to work a couple more salads into the rotation.
You want to try some like rings next door?
Sure.
That made it a little bit easier. That way we can warm your shoulders up a little bit too. Yeah. So the idea is that you can either put both hands on and keep yourself going. So like here, or you can monkey bar like through. There you go.
It's too low. I don't know if I have the upper body strength for this anymore. Some of us are built for Ninja Warrior. Some of us built more for the island. I can't even attempt to try to do it, I'm afraid. Why am I afraid?
I think we're gonna have you fence Elena.
Yeah, we have them set up as a sonic curve, so if you want to try something a little balancy.
Oh, oh, oh.
idea is like you want to put your hands this way, right? You want to pull and like kip your knees up. And so like it's almost like a pop. You want to think like explosive up with your legs up. Same idea with the devil step. So you drive your knees.
Yeah.
Drive both knees. So.
What do you got going on? That's insane. I can't even attempt to try to do it. I'm afraid. Why am I afraid?
Hey, there you go.
Let me try again.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there we go. That was it, though. That was everything you needed.
I'll tell you what, man. I got mad respect for Ninja Warriors. Because this stuff is way harder than it looks on TV. I always tell people Survivor's way harder than it looks. You're out there, you're suffering. This is way harder. And I need better fitness too.
So the idea is you step and hug it. And then work your way around and push it away.
This looks like a beginner move.
There you go. So now work your way around. And on the back, you're gonna sit into it and then push it away. Yeah, there we go.
You make it look too easy, brother. Thank you so much for the training.
No
this
problem,
was a
man.
Lot of fun. Anybody want to guess what sport used to be referred to as a king's sport? You got it, fencing. So I'm headed to the Boston Fencing Club to go duel like royalty. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Welcome. Rob.
Welcome to Boston Fencing Club, I'm Yasser.
I hear you're gonna give me a fencing lesson today.
I absolutely am.
I'm definitely in uncharted waters. I've never done anything like this before, but it's pretty popular.
Absolutely, it's for everybody from 5-year-olds to my oldest student is actually 83.
I am a rank amateur, so I see you got some kids over here starting.
Yeah.
They're ready to beat me up, yeah, I believe it. How long have you guys been here?
This place 10 years or so, but we've been around since 1858.
And you find that like there's a large enough community to warrant the space?
Absolutely.
Yeah, is it growing?
Constantly. Actually, since COVID, it has been like every day my program has grown.
So obviously this is not a real duel. We're not trying to like stab each other. How does it work?
Well, we're trying to stab each other, but not kill each other.
Ah, I gotcha.
Okay.
So how do the points work?
There are three weapons, saber, foil, and epee. Saber and foil are a little more complicated. Epee is a free for all. So from head to toe is target. If you hit, you get a point. If I hit, I get a point. If we both hit at the same time, we both get a point. We go to 5 points, and that's it.
Is there a referee?
There is a referee.
And he says, who actually got the point? Well, Yasser, I'm ready for my lesson. Should we start?
Let's do it.
Fencing has been around as a military training since the 15th century and joined the Olympics program as a sport in 1896. Continuing to thrive today, there are over 700 clubs in the United States with over 37,000 members. And it's probably because we all look pretty smoking good in this gear.
Are you ready? So you're gonna need to take that hat off, okay? 1 second, fantastic. So this is an epee, it's a little bit heavier. The bell guard is a little bit bigger so that it'll protect your hand. And then this body cord is gonna be plugged into here. Nice.
So our first position is called on guard. You wanna point your front toe forward and your back toe to the side. And then you wanna bend your knees. You want a strong base. And before you make any sort of attack, you wanna extend your arm forward. So you'll hear me say extension a lot. So the first thing you're gonna do before moving at all, just hit.
Hit it hard?
Yeah, hit me.
Fuck. Oh, I
feel it. Yeah, you do feel it. Yeah, you'll be all right.
Okay.
All right, ready? Look at these kids.
I don't have no padding in mind.
You got the,
you got even the foot guard, the arm guard, you don't got it all.
And hit. Up. There it is. Excellent. Now lunge. Up. Exactly. There it is. Fantastic. Excellent. Aha. And go to my leg. That's right. Fantastic. Now be hit to the hand.
I feel like when I do that, like when I go to your leg and leave my face open.
No matter what you do defensively, right, there's always an opening. So you have to take your shot at a smart moment.
So it's not only physical, It's also strategic.
100%.
And you're trying to get your opponent to do one thing and do something else at the same time.
Exactly.
Got it.
Exactly.
I got experience with that.
That's wonderful.
On guard. Ready?
Ready.
Fence.
Nice job. I want to put you to the test against some of my little ones here. I think we're going to have you fence Elena.
Elena, how old are you?
I'm 10.
10? I have four little girls at home, and one of them's 10. How long have you been fencing for?
I think 2 to 3 years.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, don't hurt me too bad today. It's my first time.
Okay.
All right, let's have some fun. I feel a little bit like I'm in a no-win here. On the guard.
Fence.
That's right. Oh, so close. Yes.
Oh, shut up. Elena, great job. You crushed me. Awesome job, Elena. Thank you so much for the game.
I want to learn about Tai Chi.
Drop the ball until it comes down right by your thigh.
So how would we use that, like, in a combat situation?
It's like you come out and I'm just going to bounce you.
I feel a little bit confused.
A little bit confused. Okay, that's natural.
So far on the tour of my Boston sports scene, I've boxed, fenced, and trained like a true ninja warrior. But now I'm headed to Chinatown, which is the only surviving ethnic Chinese district in all of New England, to learn Tai Chi.
How you doing? I'm Rob.
How are you? I'm Edward.
Nice to meet you, Edward. I'm so excited for today. I've been looking forward to it for a long time. I want to learn about Tai Chi.
Definitely. Welcome to Jinsun Tai Chi Federation.
Thank you. What can you tell me about this? Is it a sport? Is it a martial art?
It is a martial art. It's actually, so the Federation is the oldest Tai Chi school in Boston.
Okay.
And so a lot of people think of Tai Chi as a wellness exercise, and there is a major wellness component.
Right.
But it is a martial art, meaning that there's a combat element. So you better be ready to sweat today, Rob.
I'm ready. I mean, do I need to be in good physical shape to do Tai Chi?
No, actually, I mean, if you come in with some health problems, we'll adjust the curriculum to you. In fact, for example, we have some longtime students who came in initially with fused spines. And they still practice
really?
Today, and they're really strong.
So it's for wellness, it's also for, is it self-defense?
Well, it is a martial art, meaning that there's applicable elements to it.
To combat.
Obviously, we're not gonna say go out there and fight, right?
Right.
But you know, there are elements where, especially if you train the martial, you'll get more benefit just because you'll better know what you're doing with each move.
Well, today, I will be your student.
Yep, definitely.
All right.
Sounds good.
Should we get started?
Yeah, let's get started. So the thing you're gonna find out with Tai Chi is that a lot of the warm-ups look very simple, but they can get very hard as long as you're using mind intent.
Okay.
So intent is knowing where your hands are going, having your eyes focused where they should be, and also just listening to everything in your body. Just keep in mind you gotta keep your head up, which lengthens your spine, so you don't wanna be leaning, you know, and you wanna keep your knees in alignment with your toes so you don't hurt yourself. And everything we do shoulder width. You're just gonna sink a little bit. So when you sink, tuck your tailbone so your spine stays straight. Bring your hands up to about shoulder level, and you want to keep the arms curved. Just turn the waist till you're about 45 degrees, and then when you're at 45 degrees, bring it in. Just come back the other way, okay? And then once you're at 45, push out to about the same distance, and now turn again. So keep moving. I'm going to try to help you out here a little bit. So the goal of this exercise is multifold. You'll find that most of our exercises have multiple purposes. You're building your basic feet, you know, strength. You're also trying to isolate the waist. So
got
what
it.
You're trying to do is feel that waist. Try to keep the eyes with the fingers. So as you turn, okay, good.
I feel a little bit confused.
A little bit confused, okay, that's natural.
I'm just being honest,
It's definitely an abstract thing to learn because what you're trying to do is get that waist isolated.
Okay,
so
I got you.
That
makes more sense to me.
That's one warm up. Let's try something else. So from here, we're gonna do a ward off move. So take the right hand, so bring it up so that the thumb is about right under the height of the chin. So if you think about the name, it's exactly what's on. It's a ward off. So you're warding off a punch or a strike or something. And then the backhand, you're gonna come and put it right here like you're holding a tiny ball. And as you do that, drop the ball until it comes down right by your thigh. Then turn the ball back over. and then shift the weight forward. Bring the hand back up into the ward off. So basically, you're going from one position to the next.
So how would we use that, like, in a combat situation?
So theoretically, like, if we were doing slowly, you're coming at me, right?
Right.
And I'm gonna try to catch this and just kind of pull you down.
Pull it down.
Yeah, it's a roll back down.
Got it.
Or, like, I can roll back this side, right? And then you're really locked at
right.
that point. So, but the ward off, though, because we build the core, it's like you come out and I'm just gonna bounce you.
Down.
Yeah.
Leaves me open here.
Yeah, exactly. So there's like every move has many, many applications.
Got it. I also notice you have an array of weapons,
yes.
swords. What's going on here?
So the weapons help teach us how to apply the form. Okay, so we have two main swords for the school that are in the tradition. We have the Do, which is the broad sword, the curved sword.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the straight sword, which is called the Gim.
And what are the differences of the two?
So the straight sword is designed for applying the internal power with finesse. So we only hold it, if you look, with basically two fingers.
Okay.
So as you can tell, unlike a lot of other Chinese martial arts, our swords are heavy. It's not the floppy foil that you normally see in, like,
right.
performances. So when you hold it with two fingers, you're getting a lot of wrist action
mm-hmm.
and able to send your energy down to the tip. The curved sword, like I said, is striking with the whole body power. So the strikes with the curved sword are more like you put the whole body into it, you know. So Rob, you've done some of the basics today. You
yeah.
know, you got some foundation. You see basically what we're about here. I'm going to show you one of the exercises we do to build core power.
Right.
So we do a staff exercise. This is for building power and core energy. Okay, I'll let you feel it.
Oh, yeah.
That's heavy,
it's got
right?
some weight to it.
Got some weight
sure.
to it. Okay.
It feels like a lead pipe.
So this is like kind of a medium staff. So most people start with the beginner staff, which is the lightest one. This one, just to give you a sense of the medium staff,
yeah.
not that bad, right?
It's less
yeah.
weight for sure.
Yeah, so you're gonna try to do something very basic. So you're gonna hold the staff at the very end. So you're gonna try to come forward with the ward off straight and then come back. Yeah, there you go. So turn the hips in. There you go, yeah. So that'll extend the power forward. And then bring it back. Yeah.
You know you can't do that and not let me try it.
Okay. Just be careful.
Oh, it's heavy. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I can see it. It's
now,
hard.
Now try to get the hands together. That's the hard part.
Oh, all the way together.
All the way together.
There you go. That's awesome,
yeah.
man. Thank you for teaching me the basics today. I can tell already that Tai Chi takes a lifetime to master, but thank you for giving me the first foundation.
Well, thanks for coming in, and hopefully
yeah.
we'll see you again.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have a great afternoon.
You too.
Well, that was something. Who knew that right here in New England, we have an authentic Tai Chi studio, Olympic caliber fencing, a ninja warrior obstacle course, and a top-notch caliber boxing gym.
You know, I gotta tell you, I thought I was meant to be a ninja warrior, but after that performance, I might need to rethink that. Maybe I should just stick to television and entertaining you guys. I'm Boston Rob. We'll see you on the next one.